Good morning, children. Welcome to your science class. I hope you remember that we were studying the chapter Bones and Muscles. We also read that bones are the strongest part of our body. As there is an idol in the market or a statue, and to make that statue strong, lot of things other than mud is also used. Similarly, to make a body, lot of things are used. So a body is full of bones, covered with muscles, and then with the skin. Now, the whole body is covered with skin. You remember we read the chapter in the previous class. We started the chapter. Now we will continue our chapter. The whole body is covered with skin. Press your thigh with your finger. Now you remember I tell you can press your thigh and then see. At some part there is strong fat. There is fat. That means there are muscles. And on the part where it is soft, it is bones. When it is soft, it is your muscles. And when it is too hard, it is your bones. Now let's continue. This is your bone. When it is too hard, it is your bone. Our body is made of bones and muscles. These are then covered with skin. Now our body is full of muscles and it is covered with skin. Bones and muscles together give shape and support to the body. An adult human body has 206 bones. How many bones? 206 bones. And more than 600 muscles. That means 206 bones are there and more than 600 muscles are there. All bones together form the skeleton. Now when all the bones are kept together in a place, they form a skeleton. As they separate, these all bones are used for different purpose. Then while sketching or while doing anything different and important, then the things are kept a little different way. Now, human babies are born with 300 bones. That means initially we are born with 300 bones, and when we grow slowly and slowly, our bones join. That means there will be more pieces of bones, and now they have to, as she have learned things, she'll be able to do it. So when we grow, our body turn into 206 bones. How bones and muscles work together? Now bones and muscles work together like as different other examples work together. The muscles are fixed on the bones. When we want to move our arm or leg, muscles contract and pull the bones. Thus, bone and muscles work together on the movement of the body. Now, together they help us to control the movement of the body. Bones and muscles help us in doing activity like swimming, dancing, playing, cycling, jogging, eating, and lifting. We use our arms, head, eyes, legs, hands, and feet for doing all the activities. Can you see how children are swimming, dancing, they are playing, cycling, then eating even food, weight lifting, and lot more other things. Then we will continue the chapter in our next class, that how it is important for us to sit in a straight, that means regarding our postures. And we will also be studying regarding that how our bones and muscles together do different work. Okay. Till then, you read this chapter. Take care of yourself. See you. Bye, children.